Hi, I'm Cher, and this is The Dog Show. This week on The Dog Show...
With the question of the week. This week's question, what's the most embarrassing place your dog's ever gone to the bathroom? All right, what is the funniest place that Daisy has ever gone to the bathroom?
There was actually on the vet's table, probably, and I just said, oh look, she's scared shitless, but...
Right.
And then she was on the vet, on the vet's table.
Oh no, it's sort of sad.
I don't know if you can use the shit list or not, but she did.
We'll take it.
Yeah, she's up there. She's just like, I'm scared. I'm just going to poop on your table.
Right. And what was the vet's reaction?
He said, oh, now I have a sample. Thank you.
You skipped a step for him.
I'm sure it wasn't the first time exactly. That it happened on his table.
Yeah, I'm sure he's used to that.
Yeah.
But a little embarrassing for Daisy, perhaps. I would be embarrassed if I did that at the doctor's.
She was just nervous. But she was all right.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad that it was with someone who would understand, because maybe another table, that person wouldn't understand.
Yeah, not so much.
All right. What is the funniest place your dog has ever gone to the bathroom?
Ooh, the funniest? I guess in the bathroom, right next to the toilet.
So he missed by a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. If he could just aim it a little better, it'd be good for all of us.
So maybe with a little more training, you'd have a dog who could flush for himself.
Almost. That way I could leave and he could take care of the house on his own.
You think he was just sensing you guys were going in there and he wanted to copy you guys?
Probably. He always follows us usually when we go do our little business.
Well, hopefully the smell came out pretty quickly.
It did.
What is the funniest place that Dizzy has ever gone to the bathroom?
Funniest places that he'd ever gone. Ocean. Definitely the ocean. Yeah. Took him to the beach for the first time, and he pooed in the ocean.
What made him think that that was an appropriate place to go?
I have no idea, but it was very funny because the tide kept coming in, and he kept kind of running out. You know, it was very funny.
Are you sure that he wasn't just copying you?
I'm pretty sure, yeah, because it was number two, and that I've never done in the ocean, so.
All right, I'll take your word for it on that one, Dizzy. We know the truth, right? What's the most embarrassing place that Captain's ever gone to the bathroom?
One time he wasn't feeling well, and he had an accident on the subway. That was probably the most embarrassing.
Did everyone give you terribly dirty looks?
Yes.
And what do you do in that situation?
Get off at the next stop, clean him up, clean his little crate up, and then get back on the train and finish your trip.
Were people doing that thing where they slowly move away from you? They go to the next car?
Nobody switched cars that I can remember. But the two people sitting next to me definitely got up from their seats. Yes.
Oh, Captain, I'm sorry. That must have been a very embarrassing moment for you.
He didn't seem to mind too much. He wasn't nearly as embarrassed as I was.
Where is the funniest place that Cooper's ever gone to the bathroom?
Ooh. Gosh, I don't even know. I mean, maybe...
There's a smile developing. I think you're thinking of something.
I mean, it's not really that funny. It's just like random places in the apartment where he may have peed.
Let's hear him.
My mum's sofa. He peed on that once. I think it was by accident. I'm hoping it was by accident. Yeah, that's kind of it.
Oh, no good stories to tell us?
No good stories.
Aw. Cooper's just too good a dog, I guess.
Not really, but I can't seem to think of any of his bad experiences.
Thank you.
here with Abby from Waggy Tail Rescue, and this is
Grandpa.
Hello, this is Grandpa. He's a 13-year-old Chihuahua. He has a little bit of arthritis in his back legs. He's looking for someone that's kind of home all the time and ready to just sit on the couch with him and chill and take him for short walks. He is wee-wee pad trained and he likes to go outside. He's good with cats and good with dogs. Just a very chill, mellow dog.
He looks amazing. So someone that works from home, maybe that home office, that would be perfect. He can just lie next to them kind of all day.
Yeah, for sure. That or like maybe a retired person, someone that just is ready for a dog companion by their side all the time.
Well, Grandpa is the perfect representation of senior dogs, and senior dogs are amazing. They have so much personality. They're usually a little calmer, a little bit more laid back. Is there anything else you want to tell me about him? You said he's paper trained, right?
Yeah, he does really good with the wee-wee pad. We believe he might be deaf, but that really doesn't hold him back. He loves to sleep on the bed with you. He's a people dog, so he really enjoys being by his person and just hanging out and sleeping.
But he needs a calm home?
Yes, preferably a home without small children, someone chill that wants to hang out.
Well, he is one amazing dog. He's really cool, and anyone that really comes over and pets him, he's like, what's up?
Yeah, he definitely loves to be pet, and he likes to be in the sling, he likes being held, he loves it. He likes being your little baby, kind of.
Well, thank you so much for taking him and getting him up for adoption, and he's just a love bug.
For sure, for sure.
This is Summer for the Dog Show, and we love our Chi-Chis. We'll be right back.
here with Stephanie Matera at the Mayor's Alliance Adoptapalooza here in Brooklyn. And you're the official spokesperson for the Mayor's Alliance and the New York City Animals.
Thank you so much. Yes, it's been an honor. I've been doing this for 5 years, and we do our Adopt-a-Palooza biannually in Union Square, but today we're doing our first ever Brooklyn Adopt-a-Palooza, so it's very exciting.
And there are a lot of adoptable pets in Brooklyn. You don't even have to go out of the borough to find your new companion.
That's right. A lot of Alliance participating organizations are based in Brooklyn. We have Bark and Sean Casey Animal Rescue.
And they're both getting a lot bigger. I know Sean Casey now has 2 locations here in Brooklyn.
That's amazing. I'm so glad to hear he's doing so well.
Yeah, and also there are some small organizations that are represented here today, and I think there are so many breeds and mixes here that there's something for everyone, both cat and dog, and some of them have 4 legs and some don't, but there's companions for everyone here.
I agree. We're in high season for kittens, so we do have a lot of kittens here today, so it's wonderful. People are looking to adopt a cat today. We love that. We also love our dogs, and like you said, you can find anything, a mixed breed, a purebred dog, different ages, different sizes. There's a great mix.
Yeah, we have met some really amazing personalities of the dogs here. We met Grandpa, who's an old Chi.
Awesome.
He was super mellow. I saw some beautiful greyhounds that were really large and really gorgeous.
Yes, we have the Greyhound Rescue here. We have Husky House here. So we really try to give you a good sampling. So whatever kind of dog fits your lifestyle, you'll find that with us.
And I also think that, you know, that dog will come in and grab your heart, and that's the one.
You just know. One of my dogs I adopted actually from petfinder.com, mm-hmm. and I adopted him without ever meeting him, and I just knew. I did a lot of research on his breed in advance to make sure I was well prepared, but something about his charisma in that photo literally spoke to me, and the dog is my soulmate. Literally my soulmate.
No, I understand, because, you know, Angel Song, superstar Angel Song.
Oh, she's licking the microphone.
I know. She loves the world, and the world loves Angel Song. She's a rescue. And I didn't know what she looked like when I got her, so you know,
didn't
know.
Her.
I
wow.
didn't. But you know, when you know, you know.
You know, and she is so well matched for you. I enjoy all of your Facebook posts and this little sleeping beauty. She really is an angel. She's a beautiful dog.
She really is. I'm so lucky. And you know, take a chance on rescues because they are quite amazing. We can both attest to that.
Absolutely. I also have another rescued Japanese Chin from the Mayor's Alliance, New City's Animals. His name is Romeo, and he's 8 years old, and he was older when I got him, 7, you know? So he's wonderful. They're already housebroken, so there's advantages to rescuing an older dog.
Yeah, and usually when you adopt an animal from a rescue, they're already spayed or neutered. They're usually trained, right?
That's exactly right. They're spayed and neutered. They come fully vaccinated, often microchipped. So your dog is coming fully vetted when you adopt.
And that's really, you can't ask for anything better than a brand new, loyal companion for years to come, and they're already taken care of. They've got a clean bill of health.
I completely agree.
This is Summer for the dog show at the Mayor's Alliance Adopt-a-Palooza in Brooklyn. Thank you, Stephanie.
Thank you for having me, Summer. Always a pleasure. Thank you.
This is Summer with the Dog Show, and I'm here at the Mayor's Alliance adoption event, and we're with the Red Hook Dog Rescue, and this is Harriet, and you have Astra with you.
Correct.
And can you tell me a little bit about this beautiful pup?
She's about 3 or 4 years old. She was pulled from animal care and control off the euthanasia list. She's been in boarding for almost 6 months. We're having a hard time finding her a home, even though she's a great little dog.
She looks like she has great energy, and she would be a good walking companion for someone, maybe a single home or maybe with bigger dogs?
With bigger dogs. I think she's okay with bigger dogs with really slow introductions. She's maybe deaf in one ear, but not both, so she has some hearing problems, but she pays attention really well.
That's wonderful. Would you also tell me a little bit more about Red Hook Dog Rescue?
We've been around for several years. We kind of specialize in special needs dogs, or what people think are special needs, like deaf or blind, but we don't find them that special. We find them very special in that they're so adaptable.
And well, that's like, them. I mean, people,
we don't feel sorry for them, you know?
Yes.
They don't care. They don't know. The dogs don't know.
Yeah, no, I've seen dogs with amputation that they just learn how to walk differently, and they're fine.
You know, they're good for therapy dogs with kids and stuff, because they just see that, I mean, if they're good with people, but they see that it's no big deal for them. You know, people often feel sorry for a deaf or blind dog, and the dogs are like, I don't care.
Yeah, we have a lot to learn from dogs, but they really are very adaptable and very adoptable, just like Astra.
I mean, deaf dogs, you can take them to the fireworks. Fire trucks don't bother them. Noises don't bother them. You know, they learn by hand signals. That's how dogs learn anyway.
So they are really great city dogs if you think about it, because the city is really loud, and if they are a little more relaxed around sounds, then hey. Can you show some signals for her?
Instead of saying good dog, I always give her a thumbs up.
And she's food oriented, you said, right? She is absolutely beauty. I know she would get a good home, and you guys have done such a great job with her.
Yeah, she's a good girl.
Do you have any other dogs that you really are close to your heart at the rescue center right now that you want to talk about?
We have a lot. People can see them on Pet Finder. At Pet Finder and Red Hook Dog Rescue Facebook page. A lot of our dogs are better as single dogs.
Because they have special needs.
We have an awesome little blind dog that we just took. Okay. Her name's Michelle, but we just got her the other day.
Okay. Well, I'm very grateful for everything you do. Special dogs' needs are...
They just need more publicity. You know, I mean, people need to know that they don't have to feel that sorry for them. If you have a deaf dog, you just have to use hand signals, and probably they can't be off-leash in an unfenced-in area, or, you know, you have to watch doors opening and closing. And if you have a blind dog, you become their seeing-eye person, and you just talk a lot.
No, I think that, you know, their companionship is really what's so amazing, and you'll get that in any dog, no matter what their disability might be. But in the end, they're loyal companions, and we're lucky to have them.
Some people just call them differently abled. You know, they're not really disabled. They're just different.
Thank you so much.
That's our show for this week. You've been watching The Dog Show. I'm Cher.